Y'all already know who it is, man. It's your boy, Nenrique. They'll be doing a video discussing the truth about Greed Island. Now, when it comes to Greed Island, this arc is very controversial in the fan base. And to be honest, this is one of the only arcs that I see people bashing. A lot of people, they say stuff like Greed Island is boring. A lot of people, they say stuff like Greed Island is too long. A lot of people say stuff like Greed Island has no really relevance to the story. But today, I'll be doing a video discussing the truth about Greed Island and what do I think about this arc in general. Now, to be honest, I think that one of the biggest unfair parts about Greed Island is that it comes right after York New City. And what do I mean by that? York New City was basically one of the greatest arcs in Hunter x Hunter. Like, regardless of what comes next, like, even when we get more arcs, York New City was so great that it set the bar so high with the Hunter x Hunter. Let's be honest. You had the Phantom Troop fight going on, Kurapika. You had Gon and Killua infiltrating the troop. Like, it was just so great. Like, there were so many great moments in the York New City arc. So it had a lot of people, like, it was very action-packed too. So when we got to Greed Island, where it got a little bit slower, I don't want to say that Greed Island wasn't necessarily action-packed, because there still was a lot of action in Greed Island. It was still enjoyable, but the amount of action going on in York New City, I think it just outweighed how much was going down in Greed Island. So a lot of people, they saw that and they're like, yeah, this is nowhere near York New City, so this arc sucks. And then another thing that I gotta talk about is it was a training arc. And usually in stories, when it's a training arc in anime and manga, the pace does tend to get a little bit slowed down. But that doesn't necessarily make it bad either, because, yo, let's be honest, this training arc, it was actually one of the more enjoyable training arcs in this series. In anime and manga. I don't know why. Maybe it's because Gon and Killua, I just like them a lot. Or maybe it's because of Bisky or how they were taught. I don't know. But this was kind of their major training arc. They did get a little bit of training in York New City, but I don't really count that as a whole training arc. If anything, I would count Greed Island, because this is when they actually, like, developed their abilities. So yeah, a training arc definitely wouldn't be as action-packed as, you know, just a regular old fighting arc like York New City. But I still gotta say that Greed Island was a pretty dang good training arc, if I do say so myself. Now, the one thing I want to talk about is the relationship to the story, because a lot of people, they feel like Greed Island is just straight up filler. A lot of people feel like it's just misplaced in there, but I'm gonna be honest, I don't think that whatsoever. Me personally, after rewatching Greed Island, it has made me appreciate the arc more, because I'm gonna be honest, when I first got done, like when I was first catching up to Hunter x Hunter, I had the little bit of hate for Greed Island. I was like, oh my god, this arc is so boring, I just can't deal with it. But after I began rewatching it, and after I watched it from start to finish, I found myself like itching for new episodes of Greed Island. Like, I found myself just like, you know, I couldn't stop watching Greed Island. I was like, oh my god, this arc is so good. So yeah, definitely I think you gotta rewatch it if you want a better experience. Now I'm going to talk about the relationship to the story, because if anything, I think that this arc gets the most disrespected when it comes to how good it is or how much important it is to the story. Greed Island is, this might sound very controversial, but it definitely might be one of the most important arcs when it comes to the story, because think about it, this helped Gon get in touch with Jing and his friends. Like, we saw that Greed Island is basically composed of we know that the Greed Island, like, the name came from 10 of Jing's friends, and we know that there are still a couple more friends that necessarily haven't been revealed, so that's even more hyped. But the one thing that I gotta say is that this was a great build-up into the Chimera Ant arc. Like, if it wasn't for the whole Company On thing and him going and trying to find Jing, and then he ended up running into Kite, then the Chimera Ant arc, I'm not gonna say it would never happen, but it probably would have took place a little bit later, and I just don't think that Gon and Killua would have been as prepared for it. So this arc was definitely a very pivotal and a very, very strong point for the story. I can make an argument to say that this might be one of the biggest arcs when it comes to story-wise and transition too. And last but not least, just to debunk people, a lot of people said this arc wasn't very action-packed, but if you really look at it, this arc had a lot of action in it, whether it be from the whole Razor battle. A lot of people, they don't claim that to be like a fight, but me personally, I think that was definitely one of the most life-threatening fights in the series that we've seen so far, because remember the part where Killua basically admitted that he would have died had he made one move to the left? I was like, oh my goodness, this is getting very spooky. Like, these guys just playing dodgeball, but then like people are about to die from it. We had people getting knocked out, incapacitated. It took Gon, Killua, and Hisoka having to team up, three of the strongest people that we've seen so far, like that were hunters, you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that they're like the strongest people in the overall series, but to us, they were to the viewers, they seemed like they're pretty strong. It took three of them just to stop Razor. So yeah, this was a very, very hype and action filled arc in the series. Not even to mention the bomber moment, like when they fought up against Genthru. That is definitely one of the most underrated fights in Hunter x Hunter series, just because the logic that Gon had to use in order to beat him, summoning the giant rock, you know, getting him to be stuck in that little corner. Genthru, I surrender. Like, yo, Green Island was dope. Like, this arc was amazing, and I definitely gotta say that it's definitely an underrated arc. Now, as for my final thoughts on Greed Island, me personally, I believe that this is a very great arc. I think it's very, very underrated. And to be honest, I don't have the same hate that I have for it before. If anything, it made me love this arc even more. And me personally, I believe that's very good for the story, simply because of the transition it has into the Chimera Ant arc, and because of all the secrets that it has too. So yeah, overall, me personally, I think that Greed Island is a very great arc, very underrated. Comment you guys down below, subscribe if you haven't. Peace out.